Today's video is a video inspired by the Maybelline Nudes palette. I just picked this up. I'd been thinking about getting it for a while. I was like, oh, what the heck, I'll get it. And I tried out the colors. I love the colors in it. It's perfect for everyday look, and you can even make it smokier because of the darker colors that are in it. So it's a very versatile palette, and I just have really just been loving this and been creating all different kinds of looks. So I decided to go ahead and create one for you guys today. I used the colors on this side of the palette here. It was super simple to recreate. So if you're interested in seeing how to recreate this look, then just keep on watching.
Okay, so starting off with my face primer, today I'll be using the Maybelline Baby Skin Instant Pore Eraser. And I'm just going to be blending this all over my face using my hands. And make sure your hands are clean because we don't need to be clogging pores. And now moving on to foundation. I'm using the Maybelline Fit Me Foundation. And this is in the Dewy Finish. Mine is in 115. And I'm just going to be using a Real Techniques blending sponge. And I'm just going to be blending this all over my face to give myself a fuller coverage look and a flawless finish. And also make sure to blend into your hairline and also around the edges of your nose and down your neck because we don't want to look like a clown. Now moving on to concealer, I'll be using the Almay Clear Complexion Concealer, and I'm just using this because it's not as big of a difference in color from my foundation because it will give it a more seamless finish into my foundation. I'm going to be going and using this one because I want a natural look, and I'm just going to be blending that out using my e.l.f. blending concealer brush, I believe is what that is called. And now I'll be going into my Anastasia Beverly Hills contour kit, and I'll just be taking the banana shade and the vanilla shade, and I'll just be blending those together and packing those underneath my eyes to prevent it from creasing. Now setting the rest of my face using the Maybelline Fit Me powder, and I'm just going to be using a more dense brush so that way that foundation does not move, and again giving it a fuller coverage look. Now going back into that palette, I'm just going to be taking a bronzer from that palette, and I'm just going to be warming up the sides of my face, my temple area, down my neck, my jawline, and a little bit on my nose, but not too much because we don't want to look orange. Now taking that same brush and that center shade, because it's an ashier tone, we don't want it to look muddy. So I will just be smashing my brush and carving out the edge of my cheekbone. This helps give a more precise line to where you don't have a messy contour, and it just makes it to where you don't have to buy another brush. So for blush today, I'll be using Paradise by NYX, and I'll just be taking a small amount of this and smiling to show the apples of my cheeks to where I can get the perfect placement for it. And this is very pigmented, so be careful. Now taking the highlight shade from my Anastasia palette, I'll just be packing that on using a foundation brush because I want a very intense shimmer highlight, and this one's a more subtle one, but I'm using it because it has it more of a rose tone, and since our look is going to be in the blush nudes, that's why I went for that. Now I'm just going to be filling in my eyebrows using the Dip Brow Pomade by Anastasia and the Brow Stylist Plumper by L'Oreal. Now moving on to eyes, I will be using the MAC Soft Ochre Paint Pot to prime my eyelids, and this will just cover up all of those veins and imperfections to give us a nice base. Then going into my Blush Nudes palette, I'll just be taking this nice bronzy shade, and this is just going to go all over my lid, and I'm going to be really packing that on so I get a nice intense pigmentation from that color, and I will just be blending that just on my lid, not in my crease or anything. And also staying away from the inner corner. Then going in with a darker brown shade, I will just be buffing this in to the outer V and kind of the crease area, so that way it will act as our transition shade and as our darker color. I will just be outlining the outer corner in a V shape, going from the end of the corner of my eye and working up and back into my crease to give us a nice blended smoky look and elongate the eyes. The drought was the very worst. And I'm just speeding this side up because you saw me do it on the other side. So figured pointless to show you on both sides, but I decided to go ahead and put this clip in there, so you're getting both sides. Now for eyeliner, I'll be using just an automatic eyeliner from Ulta, and this is just a brown eyeliner, and I'm just going to be tight lining and also lining my waterline with this just to give us a darker root at our lashes but without showing an intense line that a black would give us. And I'm also going to be smoking this out with the brown that we used in the crease, and I'm just going to be taking that on a pencil brush. And I'm just going to be smoking out that brown that we put down and also adding more color to blend into the crease color that we had. So I'm just going to extend that up and connect the two. This is a great trick to do when you don't feel like doing eyeliner, but it will still give you the nice elongation of the eyes to make them appear bigger. Then taking this shimmery highlight shade, I'm just going to be highlighting my inner corners and also my brow bone with this. I'll be changing brushes for my brow bone so that way it's not so intense of a shimmer and it's more of a blended out soft look. Then I'll be going in with the Maybelline Lash Sensational Mascara. Oh, that's a tongue twister. But I will be using that as my mascara for today. And I'm just going to be doing two coats of mascara on the top and a coat on the bottom. And when you do your top mascara, make sure to let your first coat completely dry before you do your second coat. You'll get much better use out of your mascara. Then using the NYX Lip Liner in Natural, I'm just going to be outlining my lips. I'm not going to overline my lips, I'm just going to well define them because it is a very simple makeup look and we just want it to look very clean what we did do, since there's a lot that we didn't end up doing in this look as far as like eyeliner and lashes. So I'm just going to be using this and outlining and kind of blending it into my lips to where there's a more seamless edge, and it also helps give your lips a fuller appearance. Then going in with MAC's Velvet Teddy, one of my all-time favorite lipsticks, I will just be using this on top of that. And I love this lipstick because it lasts all day and it smells great, and that's really weird, but it smells great and I just love the color.
Alright guys, so that is the completed look. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up and also hit the subscribe button down below so you can see all of my future videos. And also don't forget to follow me on social media. I have Pinterest, Instagram, and Facebook. All of that is BreeBeautyXXOO, and all of that is linked in the description box and down below, so make sure to check that out. Also, don't forget to leave your suggestions for videos down below if you'd like to see any fall-inspired videos or Halloween-inspired videos or a Q&A or something different on my channel. Make sure to let me know down below. So I've been playing around with different ideas, so I want to know what you guys want to see. So don't forget to comment, and I think that's everything. So I will see you in next week's video. Bye!